Epithelial tissue is a major building block of many organs like the skin, lungs, liver, kidney, and digestive tract. Specialized epithelial cells, called endothelium, comprise the inner lining of blood vessels. While they may take a variety of forms, epithelial tissues serve an important biological function, forming protective barriers throughout the body and regulating what gets in and out. Tightly packed cells attach together with junction proteins that form selectively permeable barriers. When these barriers are disrupted chemically, through injury, or disease, this regulation breaks down, leading to a host of adverse effects. Measuring in vitro barrier integrity with TEER is a widely accepted method to quantify and model barrier function. TEER stands for Trans-Epithelial Electrical Resistance. Traditionally, TEER is measured by manually placing two chopstick-style electrodes on each side of a confluent cell layer. A low-frequency current is applied and the resistance of the barrier is measured. The easier the current flows between the cells, the lower the TEER value. This method is typically low throughput, and variability can arise from electrode placement, changing environmental factors, and more. A fully confluent layer is required to accurately measure barrier function. By integrating electrodes into the well, consistent placement is ensured with the Maestro Z, reducing variability. Up to 384 wells are measured simultaneously, hands-free. A fully controlled environment ensures barrier function can be stably monitored for minutes, hours, or days without disturbing the cells, automatically. By measuring at multiple frequencies, the Maestro Z can simultaneously track TEER and confluence. Low-frequency measurements are sensitive to the barrier properties, while high-frequency measurements detect cell confluence over the well bottom. By measuring both, differences in confluence are controlled and accounted for in your analysis. In this example, both Calu-3 and A549 cell lines are of epithelial origin, and both cell lines reach full coverage within 24 hours. However, only the Calu-3 line expresses tight junction proteins, so it produces a much stronger barrier, which stabilizes only after the cells reach confluence. Without measuring confluence, it is difficult to know when TEER will be stable. TEER may be used for disease modeling and drug development. The cystic fibrosis transmembrane conductance regulator, or CFTR protein, is an anion channel that regulates secretion and absorption in multiple tissues. Discovered for its role in cystic fibrosis, where mucus secretion may be disrupted, the channel is stimulated by cyclic AMP production. Upon stimulation, CFTR opens to allow ion transport across the cell membrane, resulting in a rapid and substantial drop in TEER. A selective CFTR inhibitor blocks this decrease in a dose-dependent manner, confirming CFTR as the underlying mechanism of the response. How could TEER help your research? Learn more about TEER and the Maestro Z at axionbio.com/TEER.